Today we are making this super tasty Bhutani Momos recipe, which is not actually from Bhutan, but it is just a Momo recipe which is very different. It has a coating outside of the filling and inside it is very juicy. You are totally going to enjoy this. I am making this in the restaurant style today and the recipe is super simple if you buy the momos from outside. Let's get cooking, guys. Welcome to CookingShooking. Let's begin the recipe, guys. First we will prepare the filling. For that here I have a food processor. You can do this step with a grater or a mixer grinder also. Here I am taking one cabbage which is of about medium size, along with that one carrot, two onions which are of medium size, and 5 to 6 pieces of garlic and about 1/2 inch of ginger. So all these ingredients we are adding it to a food processor. You can totally do this step with a grater or a mixer grinder. Just chop it very fine, guys, if you are using a knife. After that you should get something like this. This is very moist and juicy right now, so we will have to get rid of the extra moisture. So first let me remove the center column. After that we will take a mixing bowl and then we will start to squeeze out the extra moisture. Don't worry, our momos will still be very juicy. We are just getting rid of the extra moisture. Don't be very hard with it either, guys. You can see how I am squeezing it and then adding it to a mixing bowl. We will add salt to it. That will ensure this filling is juicy again. You can see the mixture is ready and we have a lot of moisture in the food processor. Don't throw away this water. We will use this later in the recipe. So in the filling portion, we will add the salt, which will be as per taste. Along with that, a little bit of spring onion greens. If you like it more, you can also add more. I'm also adding a little bit of black pepper powder and then we will mix it together to form the filling. A momo is not a momo without a juicy filling, guys. You can see how the filling is getting ready and moist again. Looks great. We will also add a little bit of oil to this. You can also add some melted butter if you want to. The fat will ensure our filling stays moist. No need to squeeze out extra water right now, guys. The filling is ready and you can add some more salt if you need to. For me it was perfect, so let me keep this aside and then we will quickly make the momo dough. For that, here I have a kneading plate. In this I will take 200 grams of maida or plain flour, about 1 teaspoon of salt, and then we will use water to make a stiff dough out of this. The dough has to be on the stiffer side. If it is very soft, then it will be a problem to shape it. Use minimal quantity of water, guys, and then you will have your dough ready, something like this. No need to add any oil or butter or ghee right now. Dough should be looking like this, but if you see carefully, this is not well hydrated, in the sense it is very rough in texture. So we have to make this smooth. For that, you have to knead this dough for about 2 or 3 minutes. After that, it will get very soft. I mean very smooth as well. It is a stiff dough, so it will be slightly difficult, but at the end you can see after kneading it for about 2 minutes or so, the dough has gotten much more smoother and softer. So this is done for now. Now we will cover this with a damp cloth and then we will let it rest for about 10 minutes. That will ensure our gluten is well relaxed. So basically after about 10 minutes or so, you can open this cover again and then you can begin dividing the dough into smaller portions. With this recipe we are making large size momos, so with this recipe you will be able to make about 18 to 20 pieces of momos or about 16 to 18 pieces depending upon your choice. So at first I am dividing the dough into smaller portions, 4 to 5 for now, but with this recipe I will make about 17-18 momos. So take one portion and then use a rolling pin and a chakla or a rolling board and then begin rolling it into about 4 inches in diameter. As with every momo video I do, I am not great at making momos, guys, in the way shaping them. So what I'm doing right now is I'm taking the filling, place about 1 or 2 teaspoons of the filling in the center after rolling it. After that you have to make the pleats. In this step, my sister and my mom are the best people around me to make the momos. So I will hand over this job to them and they will make it for me. Basically it's all about the patience while pleating it and then shaping it. It will take about 15 to 20 minutes to make all the momos. So the momos are done for me. You can surely see the difference of a momo made by me and by my sister. So you can see this one is looking great. Now we will go to the next step. For that you can see all the momos are done. You can already recognize which one was made by me. So what we will do is we will cook them now. You can either steam them or you can fry them. I will right now fry them. If you want to steam it, then you can also steam it. Not an issue. To be frank with you, steamed momos will be much more softer, so it's your choice totally. For frying it, here I have the oil which is heating up. I will just test the oil with a small piece of momo. If that fries well, we will add the remaining momos and then fry them until they are light golden. There you can see, guys, you can see our momos are getting ready. They have started to float as well. Looking great. You can also take them to golden stage if you want to, but I will cook them again in the sauce as well, so I'm not cooking them too much. This one is done. Similarly, I will fry the second batch and then we will head to the sauce stage, basically the coating stage. There you can see all the momos are done. Now let's make the sauce for it. For making the sauce, here I have a wok. You can also use a steel kadhai and that should be great. Heat it up really well and then we will add the oil to it. Here I'm taking about 2 tablespoons of oil. The reason I suggest using a wok is because it is a thin material, guys, and it heats up quickly and we get a nice smoky flavor. That is the only reason. You can totally do this step in a steel or an aluminium kadhai as well. So the oil is hot. Now we will add the garlic into it. Here I am taking about 3 tablespoons of chopped garlic. Don't cook it too much, just about 10 seconds or so. We want that raw flavor and we will add the filling to it right now. This I think is the key step for this restaurant style Bhutani momos. So just about 3 or 4 tablespoons of the filling and then cook it for about 30 seconds or so. Again, not much. We want to retain that raw flavor, about 30 seconds, and after that you can add the capsicum into it. Whichever one is available will be fine, guys. Along with that, we will also add the green chili to it. 2 green chilies I am using here, and then we will add the momo chutney. If you have the chutney available, nothing like it. If you don't have it, just mix some water with the Schezwan chutney and then you can add it. We will also add about 1 teaspoon of dark soya sauce, about 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper, and a pinch of MSG or flavoring salt. Adding flavoring salt is your choice, guys. If you want to add it, you can add it. We will also get that umami flavor from the sauces. You just have to cook this together for about 1 minute. After cooking it for a while, you will notice how this starts to thicken up and it will also start to leave the oil. That is the perfect stage. Next, we will add the cabbage water, basically the water from the vegetables, and then we will mix it. If you don't have this ready, you can also use regular water or some vegetable stock and that should be good. Since this is a wok and it heats up quickly, you will notice this gets to boiling stage very quickly. Now we will thicken it. To thicken it, here I have the same cornstarch or corn flour. Take about 1 tablespoon of that, mix it with some water, and then you will get this kind of a slurry. We will use this to thicken our sauce. But don't add it completely at once, add a little bit and then mix it. We will add the remaining of the corn flour later in the recipe. I'm sorry for this steaming shot, guys, because the room is cold and this is very hot. This is steaming up very much, so I will try to ensure this is not very steamy. This is looking good. I will quickly add the momos into it and then we will give it a stir. I will also add about 1/4 cup of water and then we will mix it. We will have to cook this for about 2 minutes or so. You can also add the remaining cornstarch and then mix it. The cornstarch will ensure the coating on the momos is thick and perfect. So that is getting ready. You don't have to cook this very much, just for about 2 minutes or so. If you have half fried the momos, then you can also add some more water to it and then you can steam it for about 3 or 4 minutes. So this is done basically. Now let me take this out to a serving plate and then we will quickly serve this. Nothing like some steaming hot Bhutani momos. I'm sure you might have never heard of it. Even I haven't heard much. I've just tried it at a single restaurant, loved it, so I'm sharing the recipe with you. And as I also said, I'm 100% sure this recipe is not from Bhutan. Just a recipe those restaurant guys thought to make it with Bhutani name. I have just finished the recipe with a sprinkle of spring onions. So guys, that was my recipe for the Bhutani momos, and as I said twice actually, this is not actually from Bhutan, just a recipe that a restaurant thought to name it. I totally enjoyed it, so share it with you. If you liked it, give it a like button and share it with your friends. If you disliked it for any good reason or any bad reason, give it a dislike. I hope to see you soon with one more delicious recipe. Bye for now, take care, happy cooking.